So, jetzt aber. Moment. Moment. Kurz das Mikrofon richten. Ich habe gerade meine FS9 gedrückt, jetzt meine Aufnahmetaste ist. Und sie hat das Spiel neu gestartet. Also zurück zum ersten. Zum Poppen. Ja, deswegen muss ich kurz mal alles nochmal. Aber egal. So, gucken wir uns mal hier um uns oben. Warte mal, Clippings.
They're fine where they are. Just some old book review clippings.
My trash can.
I don't need to take the trash out. It's not even full.
Okay. Das ist gut.
I suppose I should trim this plant. Maybe one day.
Ja, stehe ich so ähnlich. Ich bin auch nicht so der Gartentyp. Ein
Griff is fine where he is.
Griff heißt der.
I'm not up for watching a movie. Besides, I've seen all of them a dozen times.
Oh, hat er schon dutzendmal gesehen. TV.
I don't need to bother. I don't get reception anyway.
Fotografie.
It's a photograph of Auntie Lauren and me.
Das ist ein Bär.
No. I used to talk to this picture when I was a little girl, but not anymore. Auntie Lauren. She took care of me after my parents died. For most of my life, Auntie Lauren was a vegetable, slowly rotting away in a hospital bed. I don't remember what she was like before that. This picture is all I have to go by. It's me. I look scared out of my mind. I don't remember when this picture was taken, but I look about 4 or 5 years old. When I was a little girl, I'd try to talk to my younger self in this picture. I was trying to give myself advice about the future. It didn't work then, and I doubt it would work now.
Na, leider, ne? Ach guck mal, da haben wir hier Letter. Dr. Donald Quentin, Bellevue Medical Hospital in New York. Miss Blackwell, mein Name ist Dr. Donald Quentin und ich war der primäre Physiker, ich muss sagen, Arzt ihrer Tante im Bellevue Krankenhaus. Ich habe nach ihrer Tante gesehen, seit sie hier eingeliefert wurde, 25 Jahren. Bitte akzeptieren Sie mein tiefes Bedauern Ihrer Verlust. Fühlen Sie sich jederzeit frei, mich in meinem Office, in meinem Büro zu besuchen. Ich bin sicher, wir haben viel zu diskutieren. Irgendwas, keine Ahnung genau, Dr. Donald Quentin, MD. Ja, whatever.
It's a photograph.
Ja, ich will hier raus. Was haben wir hier noch? Fake
I don't need to touch it. I know these plants are fake.
Ja, sehr gut.
There's nothing in these cabinets I want right now. No. I open those curtains and a dozen windows can look directly in here. Those curtains stay shut and prying eyes stay out. Cook? Why bother, when every Chinese restaurant in the area delivers?
Eben. So, wir haben uns ja alles ab und an gesehen, den Computer noch.
I am just feeling so uninspired today. Maybe tomorrow I'll feel up to it. But today, it's just not happening.
Ah, turn off Computer. Dann lass uns mal abbauen. Und diesen Anstandsbesuch hinter uns bringen. Das Bellevue psychische Klinik. Irrenhaus, sagt man auch. Klapsmühle. Allgemein. Und Volksmund. Ja, und das Licht flackert, das ist natürlich sehr gut.
Locked. Whatever's back there, I can't get to it.
Schöne Musik.
You need a key to open it.
Okay. Wir haben hier ein.
I don't have anyone to call.
Telefon. Ah ja, ich erinnere mich wieder noch was anderes. Was sehen wir so erstmal hier rein?
So. I'm not stealing stuff from the hospital.
Warum nicht?
I don't think so. I don't think I need any of these keys.
Erstmal fragen, was mit den
What's with the lights?
Hey, old buildings, you know? Always got problems. If the plumbing ain't broken, the lights are on the blink. It's giving me a headache, let me tell you.
Okay, ja, wir wollen erstmal, er wird nicht viel wollen, das kann er wissen, glaube ich, der ist mit dem Wachmann. Deswegen sag ich mal, wir fragen mal nach Dr. Quentin.
I'm here to see Dr. Quentin.
Uh-huh. Is he expecting you?
I've got this letter right here.
Okay, looks legit. Go right in. His name's on the door, you can't miss it.
Thanks.
Sieht ein bisschen kaputt aus, wa?
Come in.
Dr. Quentin?
Yes?
I'm Rosangela Blackwell.
Oh, hello. Come in. You got my letter, I trust?
Yes, I did.
Good. My condolences on the loss of your mother.
Thanks, but she was my aunt, not my mother.
Ah, quite right.
So you wanted to talk to me about something?
Yes, I did. But before we go into that, how are you holding up?
Ich hab kurz mein Kabel hier. Ach, komm da raus. Kabel kurz mal irgendwie. Ah, Moment. Dann mach ich gleich. Expected response.
I'm fine.
That's good to hear. You received the ashes?
Yes, I scattered them this morning.
I imagine you must miss her.
To be honest, I'm not sure what to feel. It's not like I knew her, or even remember her from before. She's like a stranger.
So why did you make it a point of visiting her all those years?
She was the only family I had. I guess I felt an obligation, like I had to.
And now that you don't have to?
What do you want me to say? Auntie's dead, life goes on.
So you'll just keep living, is that it?
Yes.
Keep writing your little book reviews in the paper, right?
You know about those?
It's hardly a secret. A number of the staff have read them, yes.
I didn't think a West Village paper would interest anyone up here.
I have to be honest, Miss Blackwell. The staff read them because they were more interested in you.
Oh?
Their intentions were purely benign, I assure you. It was your aunt they were primarily interested in. They wanted to know more about her family, and you proved to be, shall we say, less than
That's their problem.
Oh, how about a trio?
Indeed. It was your choice to make. Your aunt was an interesting case, and now that she's gone, I was hoping you'd be more forthcoming with me. Just an informal chat. We can discuss her condition, and yours too, of course.
Ja, Auntie's Verfassung, die ist tot. So viel ist da nicht mehr mit Verfassung. Also, körperlicher Verfassung. Geistiger, whatever.
You never could find out what was wrong with her, huh?
No, we didn't. But she still remains a fascinating case.
Fascinating? I don't understand.
Forgive me. I speak from a purely professional perspective. I didn't know your aunt personally.
Neither did I, but fascinating?
It might come as a surprise to you, but yes.
But she was practically catatonic. All she did was lie there for 20 years. She'd sometimes twitch or mumble something incoherent, but I wouldn't call that fascinating.
Well, as you know, she wasn't exactly catatonic. We kept her sedated.
Right. She had outbursts.
Yes, and we had to sedate her heavily to keep her calm, especially in preparation for your visits.
What are you trying to say?
Miss Blackwell, we are not a nursing home. We're not content to merely keep a patient comfortable. We are, after all, in the healing profession. We were trying to heal your aunt, and to do that, we had to speak to her.
Wait, you spoke to Auntie?
We tried to.
Did she answer back?
After a fashion, yes.
Was hat sie gesagt?
If Auntie spoke, why wasn't I told?
Miss Blackwell, do you remember what brought your aunt here in the first place? Her screaming? Her hitting herself?
I was only 5 years old at the time, but I kind of remember.
In order to prevent her from doing harm to herself or to others, we were forced to sedate her. When we limited her medication, she simply reverted to her former state. Her natural state, I'm sorry to add.
What did Auntie say?
Nothing that made any sense. But one thing was clear. She was in great pain.
Pain? What kind of pain?
It's difficult to say, but it was immense.
How immense?
When we reduced her medication, the transformation was dramatic. Her eyes flew open, she thrashed, her screams. Well, we had to gag her eventually.
My God.
I know.
Did she still feel it when she was sedated?
We don't know. There's no way of knowing.
25 years.
I know.
Poor Auntie.
Tut mir leid, da ist schon irgendwie meine Maus ein bisschen.
Wait, what do you mean by my condition?
Hereditary dementia is my specialty, Miss Blackwell. And in my opinion, there is significant cause for concern.
Sorry, did you say hereditary?
Yes, two generations. Your aunt and your grandmother before her.
My grandmother?
Yes, Patricia, I think her name was, right?
I never knew my grandmother. Auntie Lauren was it. There was nobody else. She couldn't exactly provide me with a family history.
Oh, I see. I had no idea.
Well, maybe you should have. Did anyone else come in to visit her besides me?
No, you are correct. I should have read the family history more carefully. I do apologize. I just assumed. Yeah. Well, never mind. It doesn't change the fact that you should be concerned as well.
Go on.
Patricia Blackwell suffered her mental collapse at the age of 55. Lauren Blackwell underwent hers at the age of 40.
What are you saying? That the same thing is going to happen to me?
No. I'm saying that there is significant cause for concern.
So, I had a grandmother.
Apparently so.
How do you know about her?
It was in your aunt's case history when she was brought to us. Patricia Blackwell's symptoms were the same, word for word. Patricia's case was severe, and she was young, but it was chalked up to being an ordinary case of dementia. Until
it struck her daughter.
Until 20 years later, when it struck her daughter, yes.
It seems impossible.
Perhaps it's genetic, but we've detected no abnormality.
So what should I do?
Right now, nothing. This type of thing is unprecedented. There is no procedure to go through, no medication I can give you. I just want you to be aware, is all. And come talk to me if, well, there's any concern.
You couldn't find any other link between the two cases?
None, aside from the family connection. And a name.
A name? Mm-hmm. What name?
The documentation we had on your grandmother is minimal, but there was one interesting item noted. During her more lucid moments, she uttered the name Joey. Your aunt, too, would cry out that name on occasion.
Joey?
Yes.
Who's Joey?
We've been wondering the same thing for 25 years.
Ja, wir haben alles erfahren, was wir erfahren. Und wir dachten erst nur, wir hatten unsere Familie alle verloren, bis auf unsere Tante, die dann 25 Jahre hier drin war. Jetzt erfahren wir, dass unsere Großmutter genauso wie unsere Tante dieselben Symptome hatte und auch hier war. Und beide sagten zudem Joey. Die einzige Verbindung, die zwischen beiden Fällen, die absolut gleich waren im Prinzip, waren, war die Familienverbindung und der Name Joey. Und jetzt steht natürlich die Befürchtung, dass auch Rosangela irgendwie betroffen sein könnte. We will see. Ja.
Is there anything else you need to tell me before I go?
Your aunt had some personal effects in storage. As the next of kin, you're the beneficiary. It's just a folder, some documents and so on. It's being sent to your address via messenger.
Okay.
Oh, well, thanks for that.
It's no problem at all. Goodbye, Miss Blackwell. My schedule is fairly open now, so feel free to drop in anytime. I'm always happy to discuss my favorite patient.
Sure.
Ein sehr professioneller, was heißt professioneller, ein sehr, ja, aus der Sicht eines Experten, sag ich jetzt mal, da ein solcher Fall vorher nie da war. Wieder die geile Musik. Und deswegen steht natürlich so ein bisschen nicht dieses Feingefühl, was er eigentlich doch hätte erbringen sollen. Man hat sehr, sehr von der Sicht des Experten, des professionellen Manns, der sich, oder professionelle Person, die sich aus Interesse damit beschäftigt, das gesehen hat. Das war natürlich nicht ganz so geschickt formuliert. Aber auf der anderen Seite hat sie auch nicht so krass stören können, da sie kaum kannte. Also natürlich hat sie es geärgert, sozusagen. Mich jetzt auch geärgert, wenn jemand so dann redet über eine Person, als wäre es eine Sache, mein interessantester Fall. Aber dennoch, naja, sie kannte sie halt nicht. Sie wusste nicht, was war, und sie wusste noch nicht mal, dass ihre Großmutter dasselbe hatte. Sie weiß nichts über ihre Familie, und da scheint in der Familie etwas ziemlich falsch zu laufen.
I'm not ready for bed.
Ach so, wahrscheinlich müssen wir jetzt noch rüber. Ach, Quatsch. Hab's jetzt gerade erst gesehen. Geh nochmal rein, Mädchen. Hopp, hopp.
Looks like it's from Bellevue.
Ja, wie angekündigt. Dear Lauren, Oh, 25. Ach ja, ich erinnere mich, das waren eine Menge Seiten. Ich würde sagen, das lesen wir uns alles im nächsten Part durch. Ich bedanke mich fürs Zuschauen und sage Tschüss, bis zum nächsten Mal bei Let's Play Blackwell Legacy. Haut rein.